Feature Friday.
The freshest.
Señorita, Sindaji, and then the rest I don't know how to say, but it had the word señorita in it, so that obviously interested me. And I don't know what it means, but you guys said that it would be really fun if we were to check out this.
Okay.
I don't know what to expect, because obviously the word señorita means miss, or like, it's like an endearing term in Spanish of like, dear miss sort of thing. I don't know how to describe it. Like in other parts of the world, they have their own version of that. But yeah, it's from a movie, it's a video song, and I don't know who the singer is.
So okay. It's
brand new, so let's give it a watch.
Interesting. Let's have a look. Ooh, it's very flamenco.
Ah, there you go. Hispanic. That's a cajon, congas.
So yeah, it's all Hispanic.
Fiestas de what? Fiestas...
Fiestas de... Amar?
I don't know, go on. Nah.
Jardín?
Just press play.
¿Quién eres tú? ¿Dónde has estado? He removido cielo y tierra y no encontré.
Pues, so, is that, that's like an Andaluz accent, yeah,
sí,
right?
In Spanish. Yeah, it's an accent from Andalusia.
So that's a part in Spain where obviously flamenco, it's ginormous, it's a huge part of the culture. We're probably the wrong people to ask regarding the culture of flamenco. We have learned a bit through the podcast and a lot of you guys that are still watching now that are from Spain and have other influences involved. But interesting, why?
Yeah, I suppose in the story of
but
the
why is it so
movie,
popular then? Was it perhaps because it's like it was different to everything else? That's
perhaps it has to do with like the inclusion of, you know, completely different influences into the storytelling of the movie.
So a lot of you guys were saying that it was very popular and people really liked it. So I mean, obviously it's awesome.
It's fun.
But yeah, that accent, that isn't how we would speak Spanish.
No, that
in
that's...
South America.
And actually, it's very specific to that region,
yes,
of Spain.
Yeah, I think it's Andaluz.
Andaluz, yeah.
Bella,
just stunning, though, like...
Mi vida con tu
querer.
Oh! Na mejana.
Whoa!
See, that's why...
Who
that's what
thought?
That's probably why it was so revolutionary, because it created that, like, that whole wow effect, because it's the transition was so seamless, wasn't it? It was so...
That's actually odd how seamless that was.
Yeah, you didn't even know when the Spanish began and something else started. It was
see.
Really cool.
Ooh.
I love the choreo. La paella. Oh, did you catch that paella? Woo, let me just try to catch it again. Here, look at that paella. Wow.
Top notch.
Let me tell you, the bottom of that pan is worth millions.
It's actually the bottom is
it's
the best
the
bit.
The best part, the little burnt rice. Oh, with all the seasoning and the juices from everything at the top has gone down to the bottom.
Dude,
is the best.
This is a flamenco song in the Indian music industry.
It's
in
cool.
An Indian movie. How amazing is that?
It's really cool
never, combo. That's one of the things that I would have never thought was
Bollywood
a thing.
And
I don't know if
flamenco,
it would be Bollywood.
It is. This is from Bollywood.
Ah, I see. Because
yeah,
there's other film industries as well. There.
No, but this is Bollywood.
Ah,
I think I read it
okay.
On the comment section. Yeah.
Go on.
Feet. These it's guys
like...
are so big and full, and like they're so handsome looking. Like they came out of like the action figure movies. You know, like if they ever made like live actions of action figures movies.
Yeah.
But like live actions with actual people,
yeah.
They would
that's
be
what,
perfectly
is,
casted for that. They have the perfect body physics, and then they're like out there. Doing full-on fledged choreos is like the musical dream.
So in India, would like, I don't know, Latin music or Hispanic music popular? Is it popular or is it maybe not? Or is it just for this one thing, this movie?
That
would be really cool to see. Like, imagine we go there for once and then fucking someone's playing reggaeton.
Or maybe this opened the whole window of opportunity. Because when did this come out?
2012.
No, but they must have... I don't think this came out in 2012. Well, we'll do some research at the end.
Oh, let us know.
I think
in the
movie might have been a little bit older.
You
like
think?
I think
it
so.
It looks it, right?
Early 2000s, I would go with.
Go on.
We'll see. rumba. It's rumba.
Rumba, yeah.
How great.
Yeah, so that isn't flamenco. That's called rumba.
That's another style.
I guess what would you call it? Sub style from flamenco.
There's another derivative of flamenco. That's it, yeah. Torero, torero. But isn't it the transition between the two languages so seamless? Like,
very.
You really don't hear or feel the difference. It doesn't make any resistance.
And this is perhaps something that you guys, you know, because sometimes, I don't know if any of you, or the people who say that, I don't know if you're just trying to flatter us or you're actually saying it, to, you know, through all honesty. Because sometimes when we say words in Indian, which I don't know which dialect it would be, but I guess like these names, like Sindaji. Like it seems we don't do a too horrible job, and perhaps it could be because of the Spanish, like Dobara. That's probably how they would pronounce it there.
I don't know. Maybe I think the similarities maybe come perhaps from the sing-songy nature of both languages. They're both very melodic languages, so I think the similarities come from there rather than maybe more phonetic sounds itself. But like the way we intonate things in Spanish is very melodic.
Yeah.
And our inflection fluctuates a lot. And in what we've seen so far in scenes from Bollywood and how they sing and stuff, they've got similar intonations when it comes to the melody inflection that they naturally possess. And then again, it changes with each language and it changes with each dialect.
Yeah.
But specifically in this...
you can notice that what would you call it, the
similarity on inflection, it's pretty close to each other.
It's transferable to some extent. I don't know if any of you watching do speak Spanish and then have learned or maybe have gone to live in India. Was that change very difficult in terms of the language? Yeah, let us know. That'll be really interesting to know. Dude, he's huge.
Ooh, he's fantastically beautiful looking.
He's fucking huge.
I love that. That was one of the styles I learned to dance in flamenco.
Venezuela, yeah.
In rumba. Like rumba flamenca. That was one of the few things I learned.
There was this club. It was called the Hispanic Club. And it was like a country club type of thing. It had like golf courses and swimming pools. It was awesome. And when you would go there, they usually have some sort of live music playing, mm-hmm. and it would be very, you know, very, very Hispanic. That's where I think you learned this sort of dance.
I learned by watching them. Like they would perform every night, and I would go
would
around
spend time,
and,
yeah,
a lot of time. Yeah, because we worked really close to the area.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
They where we used to work in TV had ties really close to the club.
Ah, that's correct. No, the owner of the TV channel.
The ties were close.
So we used to host this TV show for kids. And just to put a bit of context, sorry to interrupt. But yeah, we used to host this TV show. There was a kids' TV show. And I think the owners, yeah, they were Spanish. And
were they?
I think they were, right?
I don't think so.
No, they had Spanish roots. What was the connection?
They just had connections in the club.
Oh, they just knew people there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, right. Well, yeah, so they would always go there after. Or that would be the place to
meet.
Like,
all the socials would be held there, yeah.
And I guess that's where we spend a lot of time for some reason.
Yeah.
And ballet, yeah.
I picked up flamenco, rumba flamenca from doing that. Nice. From watching and
oh, you're a kid. You also learn so quick.
So weird, but that was one of the few things I actually learned.
Rumba flamenca.
Yeah, because it was so fascinating. I used to watch them for hours, sitting down on the floor, just looking.
Just
up
similar to this.
Yeah.
Well, actually, it's this.
Is this that? Yeah.
They're far right.
Freaking awesome! It's freaking awesome because you have the Bollywood dance choreos influences, as well as you have the flamenco dance influences in the choreos. They're so cool. They integrated the two so seamlessly. It's so beautifully done.
Yeah.
I wonder how long it took them to film this scene alone.
It's super cool. I like this. I want to watch this movie, actually.
Wonderful. They also look like they had a great time doing this. Woo! Sick day.
Hypnotized.
Give up, girl.
It's so crazy, dude. I thought they were speaking in Spanish before.
I actually think the opening line that they had was in Spanish. Yeah, I think he said something about looking at my heart and ended up in Señorita. I think the opening line is... No, before that. De mi palpitar, I think. No? Maybe I'm just totally tripping. But I think that's what it was.
I don't know.
I thought that's what it was.
Hey, señorita.
I like it.
No desvíes la mirada. Quédate cerca de mí.
I wonder who the vocalists are. Yeah, they're really cool. Hey.
Ah, that's another thing, right? Because
the singers they do are not a lot. The actors.
Ah, yeah. Fuck, yeah.
Yeah, and so, then you hear the flamenco melismas coming through so
that,
hard.
That inclusion of melismas, which is, I think, that was one of my questions actually. How would it sound if you were to mix melismas with then classical...
Flamenco melismas with classical Indian music. Or classically influenced Indian
music. Yeah, because this isn't, yeah.
But this isn't really
But it's classically influenced to a certain extent in the terms of a... Not classically influenced this song, but I mean what it would sound like
if you were to have...
Exactly, like if you were to have maybe someone like Shreya...
singing with somebody like India Martinez.
Martinez, exactly.
Yeah.
If you don't know who India Martinez is, I would highly recommend you check out any of her... Unplugged or any of her discography, as a matter of fact, is fine, like... You would be very pleasantly
incredible.
Surprised if you enjoyed any of this.
Yeah, but yes, it's pretty wild.
That would be crazy, right?
That would be crazy.
I wonder if that's ever happened. Because here you'll see, I guess, the closest thing to that. I don't know if it's ever actually been sought out. But because she is doing melismas in a rumba flamenco style anyway. So.
Yeah. It's fun though. Yes, sir.
That guy's so fucking.
But you hear the melismas. That's brilliant. How I laugh. Oh, well, okay.
Oh,
well,
I want more, bro.
That ended so suddenly. But yeah, how fun is that fusion of things, the world coming together in a piece of music. I love that they used a rumba flamenca as the base of the song itself.
Yep.
And then they adhered both languages into that. That's really cool. It gives such a lighthearted feel to the whole song. It's fantastic.
Yeah, certainly, yeah, and Andalusia. So I think that was the accent. I don't want to obviously mishear the accent because it should be, but it's not where we're from, but it should be recognizable enough for us to be. I think it is Andalus,
yeah.
But yeah, I wonder what the reception it was when this sort of, maybe it wasn't a musical, it was a movie, right? So when these movies,
came out
and perhaps with the year, if you know.
What was the overall shock in the moment? That would have been awesome. Anyways, but thank you so much for these wonderful suggestions, and we'll be checking it out later.
Bye-bye.